Oftentimes you don't see the big back, the key back, back there returning kicks. But in this one, Fullwood is there. And Dickens hits it to Fullwood. We test him right off the bat. Down he goes hard at the 17-yard line, a driving tackle by cornerback Todd Richardson. Second down, 10 and a half, and Berger back to throw. Gets his pass away to the sideline. Caught by Lawyer Tillman just beyond the 30 and good for a first down. Berger is back to throw. Gets it off over the middle. Pass is caught by Fullwood. The tailback and Fullwood's second effort will take him for a first down at the 43-yard line. Third down and close to six. Fullwood hit at the line of scrimmage by Kirk Jarvis. Jarvis won that struggle in the middle. He got away from Tamburello. Hewlett-Back rolls it out to get away from the pressure. Gets good blocking. Throws underneath. Bell is out of bounds. No good. Alabama fails to get a first down. And Chris Moore is in to punt, averaging just over 42 yards per punt. Trey Gaines is back to receive it for Auburn. A line drive kick. He's got some help back there. Works to the sidelines, and there he is pinned down. But Auburn comes out of it with very good field position, a 41-yard punt. He's out right now. Tim Jesse comes in, a senior from up at the I-back position, and Berger throwing on third down. Throws underneath, goes to the fullback, Agee. Tommy Agee puts his helmet down and gets his first down at the Alabama 42-yard line. First time Auburn has crossed midfield, and Alabama, of course, had only three plays in the punt. Vincent Harris is in there at fullback now, number 21. Berger stays with the air game. Sets up a screen. Drops it to Jesse. And Jesse goes across the 35 and down inside the 34. Bolton is back in. Gaines is out at wide receiver. And Berger on first down, throw it. Going big. End zone, Tillman. Got to be a flag. He got tangled up with the Alabama man and was denied the opportunity to get to the ball. Ricky Thomas got tangled up with Lawyer Tillman. Will come to 20 now. Third down and 14. Burgess passes away and thrown right into the hands of number 31, Steve Wilson. Interception, Alabama. Todd has the ball. Larry Rose, who had arthroscopy on Monday on his knee and is out, probably back for the bowl game. Wes Neighbors, as we've documented already, playing with a broken right hand. And Gary Otten is not in there because of a hamstring pull. Second down and eight for the Tide from just outside the 20. There's that little delay. Humphrey pops it big, got a great block, and he's loose on the sideline. And he is finally shoved out of bounds at the Auburn 32-yard line by Sean Morris. Played at Georgia Tech and played with the Chicago Bears. It is second down and seven for Alabama at the 29 of Auburn. And this is Bobby Humphrey. He's loose. He's down inside the five. First and goal, Alabama. On third and goal from near the three, Hewlett-Back throws it in the corner. Touchdown. Tight end, Angelo Shepard. 7-0, Alabama lead, Auburn's ball. First down, they're 27. Berger pitches back to Fullwood. You don't think that man can't run? Look at that. He was a half a step from being long gone all the way to the Alabama 41-yard line where Robinson and Booth brought him down. Second down and eight. Berger back throwing again. Gaines is on the wide side. Go underneath to Fullwood. And Fullwood trying to hammer that quarterback over there. Third and a yard. Give it to the big man, Reggie Ware, in at fullback, a 245-pound junior, and he's following his line surge for what appears to be a first down. Berger has Agee and Fullwood behind him. Pitches the ball to Fullwood. Cuts it back. Gone! Touchdown, Auburn! Third down, four and a half. Jumps in motion. Shula passes. Jelk drops the ball. Couldn't hold it on the hard hit.
Well, he's out here hiking the ball with his left hand today with that broken right hand.
Well, that shows his great athletic ability to be able to knock the ball with his left hand.
Billy, thanks. Keith, up to you.
Punt is fielded by Trey Gaines. Auburn again is going to have very good field position as Gaines turns it up and crosses midfield and gets the ball down to the Alabama 42 in the I formation. That's Lawyer Tillman in motion. And Berger gives the ball. Here's the reverse. Coming around. Got Bolden. Bolden has a block on the corner. They get great leverage coming around on the reverse. And Auburn has the football. Vincent Harris now the fullback with Fullwood back at tailback. And Harris has the ball. Breaks the tackle at the line of scrimmage. And he's hot today. He runs for a first down to the 10. Picked up 11 yards on the play. Fullwood. Touchdown Auburn. Penalty flag. Hold it. Hold on to the flag. Holding. Offense. First down. Berger to throw. Swings it out. Incomplete. And he's lucky to get that one back. Big Cliff Thomas was over there and almost pulled it in. So it's a 29-yarder. With Brian Truman, the punter, holding. The snap is good. The kick is up. And the kick is no good. Bell and Richardson are the wide people on second down and 7. Shula gives it to Humphrey again, and he gets outside. Caught from behind by number 90, Brian Smith. Shula has time to the sideline. Pass good to Greg Richardson. Good for a first down at the Auburn 43. Humphrey, big hole. First down Alabama at the Auburn 23. Third and 5. Humphrey, that's a sweep. Old-fashioned power football. Looks just like a single wing coming around there, and he's got a first down as he punches it down to about the 12. Shula throws, Humphrey, touchdown, Alabama. Penalty flag.
No, there should have been a penalty flag, Keith, nope, is what I'm saying. There should have been. There was a pick play.
Second down, and they're going to call it a loss of a yard. And Berger gets the heat, but gets the pass. Oh, my goodness. It was almost picked off and then caught by Walter Reeves, the tight end.
And the outside pressure comes from the two ends. Boy, Cornelius Bennett was there first.
Here's the punt by Shulman. Beauty. Tight spiral on it. Runs Greg Richardson back to about his 22. Retreating some more. Penalty flag as Richardson is thrown down inside the 15 by Alvin Mitchell. Richardson retreating, trying to pick up some help. Gave up about 8 yards on the return, and it is flipping against Alabama.
Ironic part of that, Keith, is their worst day was against Tennessee. They romped. Their best day was against Penn State, and they were shocked.
On first down from their 6 after the penalty, this is Bobby Humphrey. It's third down and 7 for Alabama. Mike Shula rolls it out. He's got his first down, maybe dives for the marker, and it depends on what the line judge says. 1:12 to play, first half. Shula throwing, gets his pass away, and it is good to Greg Richardson, and good for a nope, it's Al Bell. Maybe where he elects to go with it. Nope, they run a draw. All that talk, and Bobby Humphrey gets it on a little delay and gets the first down at about the 26-yard line, and the clock stops on the movement of the chains with 25 seconds to play in the first half. He wants Bell going to the corner. Intercepted. Picked off by Kevin Porter. And Alabama is turned away.
Right in his hip pocket. He has the inside playing inside out. And then Briggs coming over playing free. Just picks it off. Or Porter, rather.
They'll make the snap, Auburn will, and start the clock and end the first half of play with a score. Alabama 14, Auburn 7.
It took him quite a long time to replace it with War Eagle 6. They've been training War Eagle 6, but he's not ready to face these crowds yet, and so War Eagle is not here today. Up to you.
We'll introduce you to the Falcon next week at the Air Force Academy. Bobby Humphrey carries over right tackle and picks up a couple of yards out to about the 33. Berger has time to throw over the middle, incomplete, intercepted. Freddie Robinson, number 21, the left corner. The ball was overthrown to Lawyer Tillman. This is Humphrey, caught behind the line of scrimmage. Number 99, Nate Hill from LaGrange, Georgia. Berger pitches to Fullwood. He took that first hit, kept his balance, turned around, ball comes loose. Alabama's recovered a fumble. And it's three turnovers. Three for Auburn. Third down and seven. Shula goes to the tight end, Howard Cross. And Cross can't come up with it. I think they're short a man, aren't they? There's number 63 finally getting out on the field and in position. Now they've got 11. And Van Tiffin's kick is good. It didn't appear to have all that much authority on it. On second and 10. Dumps it off to the fullback, Tommy Agee, gets a block on the corner and is close to a first down. And Jeff Berger is shaken up as Anthony Smith came up the middle and got him. Auburn is headed for the Citrus Bowl to play Southern California, which is beating Notre Dame today so far. And Alabama will either go to the Sun Bowl, or if LSU should lose to Tulane tonight, the possibility still exists, Alabama could go to the Sugar Bowl. Berger steps away from the pressure, throws as Davis gets to him. Penalty flag is down. The pass is incomplete. But at the same time, Auburn has been unable to move at all against the Alabama defense here in the third quarter. Shula back to pass. Swings it out to Humphrey coming out of the backfield, and he will have his first down as he got just past the marker by a yard. 5:27 to go in the third quarter. And this is Doug Allen. And Allen having a big day. Kevin Porter, for the second time, makes the play on that sideline. Auburn's defense right now really needs to take a hold of things because Alabama's just eating up the clock. 2:24 to go on the third quarter. Shula, incomplete, intended for Angelo Stafford. From the 21, Auburn goes to work, first down. Tim Jesse is the tailback. He's got the ball, bounces outside, breaks into the clear, and was close to going all the way. They are third down and seven. Berger's pass is away, and Jesse loses his footing and goes down. And a penalty flag. We got a personal foul call against Alabama.
Here it comes right here. Here's the end of the play. They called that spearing. Didn't even make contact. Most penalized team in the history of the school of Alabama.
On first down, Berger gets some protection this time. Throws complete down around the 34-yard line to Lawyer Tillman. All right, who's the strongest in the fourth quarter? A 17-7 ball game. Alabama leads and Auburn now. Second down and three. Give it to Fullwood. He pops out of there. He's on the way. Touchdown. First down, leading now by three, and pitch it to Bobby Humphrey, coming around the corner. Just over the 35. Inside, Doug Allen, and Allen is close to another first down. Penalty flag, Allen with the ball. Auburn may get dinged here with an offside. With Bo Wright in at fullback for the first time today, giving Doug Allen some rest. And this is Jokes. Pops out of there, and he is on his way. Knocked out at the three. Kevin Porter saved the TD for Auburn. Nope, it's a clip. Shula to Richardson, dropped it. To try a 39-yard field goal. He hit one from 29. From this distance, he's 3 for 3 for the year. He's 13 out of 16 in field goals this season. Plenty of leg. And no good. He missed it. A.G. is back in there at fullback. And this got pass all over it. To the sidelines and caught out of bounds by Trey Gaines, or is it good? They're going to give it to him. It's second down and 6. This is Fullwood bouncing outside. He's going to have his first down, caught from behind by Wayne Davis. Otherwise, he might still be running. Back goes Berger to throw it. Gets it away. Pass is good for the tight end. They must have heard you. Walter Reeves. And that's good for a first down, appears to be. Third down and 2.5. Fullwood. Fighting, gets the first down. He was almost down in the backfield. Greg Gilbert almost had him. Third and 10 for Auburn. Pressure coming, good protection. Berger's pass is away for Tillman. He's got it inside the 25, down to the 21. He caught it between double coverage. First down Auburn, Alabama 21. Jesse drops the ball, fumbles it away, and finally recovers it back on the 31. Berger throwing. Throws for Tillman, intercepted at the 4-yard line. A fight for the ball, and Kermit Kendrick comes down with it. Second down and 3 as they got 7 yards on the carry by the fullback, and he's got about 7 more as he comes up to the 18 and picks up a first down before Kevin Porter brings him down. Third down and 7 for Alabama. Big play here with Auburn's to get the ball back. They hand it off on a little delay to Bobby Humphrey, and the Packers handle him at the 25, and it'll bring up fourth down. Fullwood's going for it. And he may have it. Now on third down and 3.5, you've got Ware, A.G., and Jesse in the backfield, and this is Berger with a ball, and Berger is at the line of scrimmage, and that'll do it. Fourth down, 3.5 yards, Auburn's ball. Interesting that Berger had gone to the sideline with the tight end. Reeves. To the 40-yard line, caught by old reliable Trey Gaines. And Fullwood checks back in. First down, just short of the Alabama 40, and Fullwood with a hole on the right side. Pops it, keeps going, down to the 20. Well, it's a 21, handed inside. And down to the 10-yard line goes Tommy Agee. Agee with his biggest run of the day. Second down. On the 8. They run a reverse. It's Laurier Tillman carrying the ball. Good cut. Touchdown, Auburn. Third and 10 and 13 seconds. I don't know that this would go down as much of an upset, though, because these two teams are pretty well matched coming in. Auburn 8-2 and Alabama 9-2. Shuler running away from the pressure. Look out. He's over the line of scrimmage. You can't throw it. He goes out of bounds and stops the clock with 6 seconds to play in the game. Arthur Johnson is playing center field along with Carlo Cheatham, so there are 2 of them way back down on the 15-yard line. Mike Shuler gets it away, and it's in the crowd, and it is batted down. And Auburn has won the ball game, beating Alabama 21-17, and the Tigers finish their season at 9-2. Alabama finishes their regular season at 9-3. Alabama having played last August in the Football Foundation Hall of Fame game up in Meadowlands.